The topic for today's discussion is spatial filters. We need to know what is a mask before going into any filtering. Now, a mask is an image simply where some of the pixel intensity values are zero and the others are non-zero. Wherever the pixel intensity value is zero in the mask image, then the pixel intensity of the resulting mask image will be set to the background value, which is normally zero. Now here we have spatial filtering approaches are useful in image processing, and the mask themselves are also called as the spatial filters. Now, when we look into the classification of spatial filters, basically there are two types, linear filters and non-linear filters. And in that, the filter categories are low pass filter and high pass filter. So we are going to see what are the frequency responses of a low pass filter, high pass filter and a band pass filter. Now the first diagram tells you about the frequency response of a low pass filter. In this, let us say a low frequency details correspond to slowly varying components of an image. So when we employ a low pass filter to a process with an image, that allows only slow varying image details and attenuate heavily the details corresponding to edges and sharp transitions. Further, it results in a blurred image. So the second response we are going to see is for a high pass filter. So when we employ an HPF to process an image, the details corresponding to the edges and other sharp details are highlighted and low frequency details are attenuated. Hence, the HPF can be used to obtain the boundary of the objects and other sharp details which are available in an image. Now, the third type is a bandpass filter, where this removes the selected frequency regions between the low and the higher frequencies. These filters are used for image restoration and are seldom of interest in image enhancement. In general, in all the spatial domain filters, a mask with its coefficient are used to find the sum of the products between the mask coefficients and the intensity of the image pixels under the mask at specific location in an image. So let us consider a mask of 3 cross 3 with the values where we have W1, W2, W3 till W9 are the coefficient of the mask. And let us assume that the gray levels of the pixels under the mask are Z1, Z2, Z3 till Z9. Then the average response of the inner mask is given by R is equal to 1 by 9, W1, Z1, W2, Z2, till W9, Z9. Then the pixel, the center pixel value at the location X, Y is replaced by the response RA, which is obtained above. So here we have the smoothening filters, which are used for blurring and for noise reduction. Now there are two types of smoothing filters. The first is spatial low pass filter and a median filter. When we see about the spatial low pass filter, it is used to reduce the noise such as bridging of small gaps in lines or curves in a given image. As the size of the mask increases, the smoothening effect or the blurring effect also increases. So moving on to the shape and mask of spatial low pass filter. The first one, let us see the shape of a low pass filter. This is how the spatial low pass filter's response is going to be. And moving on into a 3 cross 3 spatial mask, all the values are going to be 1. And here we see that in this particular filter, the earliest arrangement is to have a mask in which all the coefficient have a value of 1. Now for a 5 cross 5 again, and for a 7 cross 7, all the boxes are going to be filled with mask value 1. Now we need to know here, as the size of the mask increases, the smoothing effect or the blurring effect also increase. So here the median filter was initially introduced in signal processing by Tucci. Statistically, a median for a given vector of values is the middle value after sorting it. In image processing, median filtering is performed by selecting a neighborhood size for the mask and moving this mask through all the pixels present in an image. The filtering is provided within a local kernel neighborhood by sorting the pixels according to their intensity values and by replacing the corresponding pixel with a median value. So let us consider an example here. In order to perform the median filtering, we need to consider a 3 cross 3 mask in the previous slides, which has the value of 1. And we are going to place the mask in the top left corner and read the pixel values below the mask. And then the second step is, let us arrange all the pixel values in ascending value. Now, this is the example what you have considered. We are going to place a mask, a 3 cross 3 mask on top of the pixel starting from the top left corner. And the next step is we are going to arrange it in the ascending order. These values, the pixel values which are here, are arranged in an ascending value starting from 5, 14, 17, 29, 38, 42, 66, 91 and 111. Now we are going to find out what is the middle value. So the middle value which is given after sorting is 38. So the center value is replaced by the middle value which is got here, which is 38. So one more example we are going to see for a median filter. Now here the values are very clearly given, and a 3 cross 3 mask is going to be placed from the top left corner and it is going to be moving around to find out the appropriate value. Now the first one is you are going to sort it out and write it in the ascending order, and you're going to find out the middle value. Now as of here, the middle value is given as 96, and the center pixel of the matrix is going to be replaced by this median value 96, that is 255, which is shown in the picture, is going to be replaced by 96. The procedure is repeated for moving the mask from one position after another until the last pixel in the image is going to be processed. And we also say that the median filter performs better than the low pass filter under a noisy environment. The type of noise which has to be studied while studying the filtering is the salt and pepper noise. Salt and pepper noise is a form of noise which is sometimes seen on the images. This noise can be caused by sharp and sudden disturbances in the image signal, and it presents itself as a sparsely occurring white and black pixels. An effective noise reduction method for this type of noise is a median filter or a morphological filter. So let us consider an input image and how the outputs are going to be is that with the help of the salt and pepper noise, now in the first box which is given here, now consider here you have a one in the picture. So one is going to be put in the center place and the places corresponding to one, that is the entire vertical row as well as the horizontal row which is corresponding to one will be of white and rest of the value will be in black. For example, if I'm going to place 2 here, that is the second value, 2 is going to be placed in this particular box. So the places where 2 corresponds is this. So the entire row is made white here and others are black. For example, the third one is 3. So I have a 3 here. So the corresponding values are this entire row has 3 and this column has 3 and this row has also 3. So the row as well as the column is left as white and the others as dark cells. Similarly, let me just tell it for 6. So let me consider 6, and 6 is in this particular row, is common for this particular row as well as this particular column. So hence this column and this row is white and all the others are black. So this is all about the salt and pepper noise. And this shows how an output is going to be after denoising a particular original image. Thank you.